With this trade, I reached my goal to withdraw money from one of my trading accounts as I normally do, but this time was a special and important withdrawal for me and my family. Because with this withdrawal, I completed my goal to pay off my first house mortgage. I currently live in my second house that I paid cash for while still living in the first house. The second house was a really good opportunity I couldn't let pass by. It was a bigger house for a very low price from an older couple that needed to move to a different state to be closer to family. So the best option to me was to take the opportunity and use the cash I had to purchase the house and let some tenants pay the monthly mortgage of the first house while rebuilding the cash I used to get the second house. So the first house I just paid off is a rental property that also brings me income. So this is a true story about how trading changed my life. And it seems like yesterday when in 2006 I came to America with nothing. And today I have a beautiful wife, two beautiful daughters, and no debt. And in less than 10 years, I have achieved the American dream. It all began when I met my wife. I was very lucky that she accepted, believed, and loved me when I didn't even own a bicycle. She was an educated person already and had what seemed at that time better opportunities, but she rolled the dice by choosing me. Now you know how I got my green card. Then a year later, I started working at a trading company here in Florida in 2007. And there I learned a lot about what not to do in trading. They also own a broker, so I learned about manipulation and the real banking and broker's business model. And more important, I talked to a lot of people that were trying to make a living or at least have extra income trading in the financial markets. I heard the struggle, the repetitive mistakes, reactions, beliefs, frustrations. I learned a lot about human nature when dealing with money and uncertainty. Inside the business, both the trading industry and the trading education industry gave me important insights that I know for a fact that I will never realize in any other way. It was a combination of witnessing contradictions and connections as well as coincidences that led me to curiosities that helped me discover and realize why trading becomes very complicated. And the odds are so against the retail trader that allow me to pay attention to other knowledge that had nothing to do with trading. And paying attention to the same charts that everybody were looking at, but with a different mindset. And then finally, all those connections fell into place and the eureka moment just splashed my body and mind, and I will never forget how I felt in that moment. So by 2011, I was no longer with this company. I had already learned what not to do. And an advantage I had was that while getting all these insights, I was getting paid for and making money trading at the same time. This is where the lucky part of my story is, because I didn't try to find trading. Instead, trading found me. I never imagined I was going to be trading for a living. So after I left this company, I continued trading. And I haven't had an employer since 2011, and I'm not planning on having one in the future. Something I realized inside the trading education business is that it's unscrupulous because they try to squeeze as much money from you as they can. This is why it's always in different levels or classes, when in reality there's no such thing as experienced traders and novice traders. This concept is based on the idea of knowledge, because based on this concept and idea, you sound like an expert when talking about indicators, time frames, volume, theories, etc. And when someone just beginning the trading journey hears all this language and terminology, of course, he or she feels like a novice. But when you truly understand that no matter your level of experience and knowledge based on symbols and hypotheses on past data, you are free of all this pseudo knowledge, because at the end of the day, nobody really knows what is going on and will happen behind the charts. The market as a whole moves because of different factors, and the market is not a person that knows that I, you, or that expert exists. So the difference, therefore, in reality is that a successful trader is not the one that knows more than others, but the one that has better habits than others and acts upon them. It's not that in order to be a successful trader, you have to know what, and what is going on behind the charts and what will happen. But instead, you very clearly know why you are doing what you're doing. That means you must have a very clear and high sense of awareness, being able to know at all times what you are trading, why you're trading it, when you're trading it, and how much you are trading it, how many times you're trading it, and until when you are trading it. Once you reach that point of knowing very deep inside your head and self-consciousness why you're doing what you're doing, if you achieve this level of consciousness, you will succeed. No matter if you just started 2 months ago, 1 year ago, 5, 10 years ago. When understanding the conditional price principles and unconditional manipulation that is necessary in the financial markets, you understand that we are all in the same levels as retail traders, and that is a matter of knowing and dominating ourselves to adapt, and not a matter of dominating and knowing what others do. When you have a simple rule to adapt, it is not because what you are doing is correct or incorrect according to popular wisdom, because that does not exist. There's no such thing as a correct or incorrect approach in a constant process that keeps moving and moving due to different reasons. But as long as what you are doing is personally understood and is based on unconditional principles, is all that matters. But as you can understand, it's about knowing why I am doing it, not why others are doing it. And this is why successful trading is 98% mental and not really technical at all. So in order to trade successfully and take advantage of the constant movement of the markets and make money as extra income or a full-time activity, you do not need to spend countless time looking at charts or doing back testing or read dozens of books about technical analysis or have huge amounts of money or automated systems, or the years and years of experience that another individual has. As I said, successful retail trading is more about inner transformation and simple adaptation than knowledge of external factors that you do not control. And this is why trading reaches a point where it becomes lonely and somehow boring. So I have a lot of spare time, and I know a lot of you guys are trying to figure trading out, and I know the tons of information you have to deal with out there. So the purpose of this YouTube channel and the concept Trading with Logic is that I can help you to know what not to do and what not to follow. So you start to question 99% of the popular information and wisdom. And if you think about it, if that is possible, if you really do not need anything from the popular wisdom to become profitable, you will be filtering and saving a lot of time, energy, and most likely money. I will try to help you and guide you so you become more aware, think differently, make different questions, and start thinking on your own, so you can have better chances of surviving and making money in this business. Subscribe to this channel. I would like to hear your comments and topics you might want us to talk about. And also, you can check our website, tradingwithlogic.com, like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter and Instagram. And thank you for listening to me. This is Luis Morelos. And remember, trade with logos, trade with logic. Until next time.